Welcome back to The Person Everyone Needs. I am Webb Hoggard, and today I want to talk to you about a few things that have been on my mind recently, a few characteristics that I think could make you head and shoulders above most of the people that are near you. The person that everyone needs is always someone who is looking to impact other people, but it's also someone who's always looking to grow. And so these are four or five characteristics or traits that I think every one of us could use to grow in. So the first one would, in my mind, be honesty. Honesty is one of the most important things for myself. When I see a friend, and knowing that I can trust what they say is one of the most important things in our relationship. Now, a lot of times people take the idea of, you know, well, I'm going to be honest. I'm going to tell you the truth, but they say it the most, you know, abrupt or rude or untactful way possible. And we don't have to be untactful to tell the truth. You know, you can be clear and kind at the same time. In fact, the second thing after honesty would probably be considerate in my mind. The scripture says, tell the truth in love. We ought to tell the truth in love. We ought to be thinking about how to lovingly, empathetically take care of other people. And when we tell them the truth, when we lead them in to paths of rightness and righteousness, then, you know, we need to be mindful of what is the right thing to say and what's the right thing to do. So I think that increasing in honesty, increasing in consideration is a big deal. I think the third thing that I would say that we should increase, and probably where I'm going to spend most of our time on today, is curiosity. I am overwhelmed recently with the idea that we are largely losing our curiosity because we have so much of our imagination is laying dormant because of the hours that we take in on social media through Reels or TikTok or whatever it is that most people are looking at. We don't learn anymore how even to be imaginative. We've killed our imagination because people who are out there as influencers is what they say, but whatever it is that they curate to put out for entertainment use, it allows us to sit back and enjoy what they have put out instead of being people whose curiosity overtakes us and we learn new things about ourselves and things that we love. George Washington Carver is one of the greatest minds in American history, and he just had a genuine, extreme curiosity about agriculture. You probably know him because of peanut butter or some of the things that he did. I think he found 300 uses of the peanut. I think he found like 150 uses for the sweet potato. I mean, he did a lot of incredible things with that. He also found out how to make things grow faster and bigger, and he just was seen as an agricultural genius, but it was because he had a curiosity and he would not let the curiosity leave him alone. He would continuously do his experiments and he would try new things and he would enjoy himself while he did that. Now, I just encourage you, if you find something in your life that is interesting to you, let me tell you, first of all, you don't need an audience to be curious. You don't need somebody else telling you, wow, that's a curiosity worth having. You don't need to have a group of people around you to say that's interesting. You should find some things in your life that you enjoy and then just do those things with all of your heart. I love books. I wish I liked to read them as much as I like to collect them, but I love books. And I'm looking right now and I've just got a whole stack of books here beside me. And any chance I can to go into a thrift store to find a few finds that are, you know, sometimes they're 10 cent. I mean, my goodness, what a cool habit to have. And then I think to myself, well, you're just wasting your time. You're just wasting your... No, it's a fascination I have. I enjoy going in places like that and finding that. I should allow myself to have some curiosity. What might I find today? What might I get into today? Maybe your thing is fishing or hunting, or maybe you have a genuine fascination with a sports team. I don't know what it is that you enjoy. Maybe you like to go for a walk, or maybe you like to look at animals. Some people seem to have out there things that aren't culturally a trend. And so I would say, be curious. Let your curiosity take you to places like George Washington Carver. Over time, your curiosity might make you seem like a professional or like a genius because you care about the same thing for a long period of time. Some of you are probably, you know, if if any guys are listening to this, you might be a handyman. Well, if you were to continuously do that over time, eventually you will be seen as someone who gave your whole life to something. I'm a preacher. I like to read about the Word of God. I study hard, and I don't want to take, you know, I want to give it all I've got right now, because I plan to do this for 30 or 40 more years. And I'd like for people to be able to see a progression that toward the end of my life, they'd say, wow, this guy was a professional Bible scholar. He's a, you know, all those things that a piece of paper at a school doesn't actually explain whether or not you are an actual guru. It's your fascination with it. How much do you look at it? How much do you care about it? Let me say something else too. When it comes to being the person everyone needs, your curiosity level of other people is very much noticed. I said this in the last podcast, but I just don't seem like I can, I don't feel like I can say it enough. Ask questions. The most powerful thing you have in your arsenal of relationships is asking questions. Take time to find out where other people's stories are, who they are, where they come from, where they want to go. Ask them about their dreams. I'll never forget a friend of mine named Alec asking me about my dreams when he was graduating college and I had another year left. And he asked, and I had never been asked that before. And I just dreamed with him and I got so excited. And now I want to breathe life into as many dreams as I can. Be curious. Ask people where they come from. Ask people what they're hoping to see or accomplish or dream about. Questions is how you get to know people, is how you let them know how important they are to you, and is how it really can change things. So curiosity, obviously, is the second, the third one, I guess, of the traits I wanted to say. First was being honest, honesty. The second was considerate. The third one is curious. And I guess the fourth one I'd like to mention to you is accountable. You're not going to get very far in your life. You're never going to grow unless you're able to submit yourself to someone who's better than you. And we're kind of taught in this culture to never think of anybody better than us, right? We're not supposed to think that anyone is greater. We're supposed to have, you know, self-image, you know, taken care of and all this positivity and all these things, which is great. Please be positive. Hey, you've got what it takes. I can't take, you know, I can't take that away from you. But I would say, if there's somebody near you that is succeeding at something better than you are, I encourage you, why don't you reach out and get curious? Ask some questions. Tell them, I need some help in this area. I've recently recognized that I'm running aground in some things with my boys. I love my boys. I want to be their first connection when they need help and wisdom and that kind of thing. But what I'm realizing now is that there's some things that are happening as they're turning, you know, into a teenagers and all that. They're not teenagers yet, but they're definitely trying to act that way, that if I don't get some control over my concerns or my irritations, I'm not going to be the kind of person they want to come and talk to. So I have decided that I'm going to reach out to some parents that I see getting it right and let them hold me accountable, because I want to get this. I have to get this right. I mean, of all the things that I want to see by the end of my life, I'd love to have written a book. I'd love to teach at a university level. There's a lot of dreams that I have in my heart, but of all the things that I really want to do, I really have to get this parenting thing right. I want my sons to always, always, always look to me for leadership, for guidance, for help. And so I'd say the last thing I wanted to, the last little trait is the trait of liberty. So hold yourself accountable. Ask somebody, you know, submit yourself to someone else and allow them to help you grow. But the other one is liberty. Live and let live. Let other people do what they feel like is right for themselves. And don't ever waste your time trying to control other people. Let them go. Let them decide what they need to do. Give them advice if they ask for it, but don't even expect them to request advice. Don't expect people to be as curious as you ought to be or as you are, because that's not always going to be the case. So my encouragement is you will stay up a lot later at night and you will be a lot more frustrated if you spend your days wanting to control, not really control, but even to influence or change or make somebody think about things that you think they ought to think about. If you'll just take your hands off the wheel and let them go, you'll be in a better shape. So that's my encouragement to you. Those five things: be a person that values honesty, consideration, curiosity, accountability, and liberty. And I believe if you do those things, everybody around you will recognize you as the person that everyone needs.